First, compile the temperature and humidity measurement source code and upload it to TBW. When the module comes close to the heating device, the measured temperature gradually rises, and the measured data value can be checked through a serial monitor. Compile and upload the barometric gas measurement source code. When uploading is complete, it starts measuring air pressure and gas in real time. When gas is injected from a lighter, the rise of the gas measurement value is confirmed by the serial monitor. Compile and upload gesture-aware source code. After uploading, sensor will recognize the moving direction if you lightly move your hand. The recognized direction can be checked through the serial monitor. What you see now is the process of temperature data transfer using mesh network. The master or root node that needs to be connected to the network first tries to make a Wi-Fi connection. When the connection is complete, it waits for a connection to the neighboring node. When a new node is connected, it outputs the information of the connected node and the data transmitted from the node to the screen. Depending on the user's program settings, the type of data to be transferred can be changed. In this demo, you can see that the temperature data is being sent. Slave or leaf node periodically reads the sensor data at the first operation, and it tries to connect to the nearby master or root node while transmitting the data. Currently, IFTTT service is used to transmit temperature data to users' mobile phones or tablets. If you connect Wi-Fi when transferring data, it will send the specified message to the IFTTT service. When a message is transmitted, the IFTTT performs services such as giving an alarm or sending an email to the user according to the type of the delivered message. In this demo, I created a very hot event for the IFTTT service to transmit the temperature value. This event is triggering an alarm on your phone or tablet. It can be also checked through the Android application.